This video was made possible by Wix. If you are ready to create a website, head over to wix.com/go/infographics to try out one of their premium plans right now. Most of us probably don't yell every day, but we are no strangers to hearing yelling. Small children frequently shout at shopping centers, and we hear loud shouting at rock concerts and sporting events. Over the years, there have been contests such as the World Screaming Competition held in Thailand in 2009. What has not been attempted before is yelling on a worldwide scale. Today, we will examine some of the possible effects of this unusual sound experiment in this episode of the Infographics Show, What Would Happen If the Whole World Yelled at the Same Time? Before we begin, we should discuss what sound is. Sound is a vibration that has pressure and moves in the form of waves. A 17th century scientist named Robert Boyle discovered sound cannot pass through a vacuum. It can only travel through a medium such as air or water. Sound is measured in decibels. The decibel scale is a logarithmic scale, not a linear one. It is based on the powers of 10. According to one source, if one sound is 10 times more intense than another sound, then it has a sound level that is 10 times x more decibels than the less intense sound. The starting point of the decibel scale is called the threshold of hearing, or TOH, which is the faintest sound that a human ear can detect. It is assigned a sound level of 0 decibels, abbreviated 0 dB, and corresponds to an intensity of 1 times 10 to the negative 12th W/m². Here is a chart of the decibel level. As you can see from the chart, the sound of rustling leaves has an intensity level of only 10 decibels, not 100 decibels, even though it is 10 times greater than the threshold of hearing. The sound of a whisper has an intensity level of only 20 decibels, even though it is 100 times greater than the threshold of hearing. To get an idea about how many decibels of sound can be created by a large group of people, we looked at the current world record for the loudest crowd in the world. According to Sports Illustrated, fans of the Kansas City Chiefs set a new Guinness World Record for the loudest outdoor stadium in 2014 when their noise level peaked at 142.2 decibels. More than 76,000 people were in attendance. Using this data, we were able to come up with a rough estimate of how many decibels of sound would be created by the population of the entire world, which is currently about 7.6 billion people. If one stadium filled with 76,000 people created a sound that was 142.2 decibels, then 10 stadiums would create a sound that is 152.2 decibels. Working our way up to 100,000 stadiums, which is the equivalent to 7.6 billion people, we find that all the people in the world could reach a sound level of 192.2 decibels. Here are some of the effects that this level of sound could cause. Number 1. Ruptured eardrums. Depending on the duration of the sound and one's distance from the source of the sound, the whole world yelling at the same time could cause some potentially serious hearing problems. Various sources indicate that sounds reaching 150 decibels or higher can create enough pressure to cause human eardrums to rupture. WebMD notes that this is due to the pressure tearing a hole in the tympanic membrane, which is located between the outer ear and inner ear and helps to convert vibrations to sound. Some people do not notice that their eardrum is ruptured, while others experience various symptoms that include ear noise or buzzing, facial weakness or dizziness, or hearing loss that may be partial or complete in the affected ear. In most cases, ruptured eardrums heal on their own, although it may take several months. Some seriously ruptured eardrums may require treatment such as surgery. Number 2. Other hearing problems. Even with a short amount of exposure, hearing the whole world yelling at 192.2 decibels could lead to other serious hearing problems. One noise reduction website notes that noise levels above 140 decibels are not considered safe for any period of time, and that at 140 decibels, immediate nerve damage can occur. According to the American Speech Language Hearing Association, short, loud noises can damage delicate hair cells located in the cochlea, which is the main structure of the ear that is responsible for hearing. These sensitive hair cells help transmit vibrations into electrical signals that your brain translates into sounds, and the hair cells cannot be fixed once they are damaged. This damage can cause a variety of hearing problems, such as noise-induced hearing loss, ringing in the ears called tinnitus, and an extreme sensitivity to sound called hyperacusis. using ear protection would not be enough to reduce the sound to a safe level. According to one source, properly fitted earplugs or muffs reduce noise 15 to 30 decibels. With a noise reduction of 30 decibels, the sound would still be high at 162.2 decibels. Protection from a combination of earplugs and earmuffs, which would reduce the sound by an additional 10 to 15 decibels, might possibly prevent eardrum rupture, but not the other hearing problems. The sound level would range between 147.2 decibels and 167.2 decibels. Number 3. Shattered glass. Theoretically, it is possible for 7.6 billion people yelling at 192.2 decibels to shatter glass, but only under certain conditions as outlined in a Live Science article. First of all, everyone in the world would have to yell at a frequency or pitch that is the same as the resonant frequency of the glass, which is the frequency that would cause the glass to vibrate enough to shatter. Second, the glass would have to be made of a material that is prone to break easily. Thin glasses and glasses with tiny fractures are a good choice. Third, the yell would have to last long enough to cause enough vibration for the glass to shatter, which one source estimates is at least 2 or 3 seconds. There would also have to be some way to concentrate the voices of 7.6 billion people into a single sound source directly in front of the glass. It is easy for one person to put a glass right next to his or her mouth before sounding off, but how could 7.6 billion people get that close to the glass at the same time? Number 4. Lots of watts. Sound exerts a force that creates energy. According to Physics Central, the average human yells at about 80 decibels, which carries along with it about 0.001 watts of energy. That seems like a minuscule amount, but when 7.6 billion people yell at the same time, they produce an impressive 7,600,000 watts of energy. Using data from the Northwest Power and Conservation Council, we find that that's enough power to keep a traffic signal operating for almost 2 years. The concept of converting sound energy from yelling into electrical energy is not as far-fetched as you might think. The Daily Mail reports that Thorpe Park Resort outside of London recently installed kinetic energy harvesting devices on all the cars of its attraction called The Walking Dead: The Ride. These devices will not only suck up the energy of screams, but that from G-force and vibrations too. The energy collected by these devices will be used to charge cell phones after it is transferred to an on-site mobile charging point. The whole world yelling at the same time will probably never happen. Gathering 7.6 billion people together in one area and coordinating them to yell at the same time seems like an impossible task. And giving the whole world voice lessons so everyone could reach the right pitch to break glass also does not seem very realistic. However, if it did happen, it would be amazing. Here at the Infographics Show, we wonder about crazy things like the whole world yelling all at once so you don't have to. But one thing that we never wonder about is how to make an amazing website. Wix's 500 templates let you get started right away designing a site that's just right for you. And with easy drag and drop, filling that site up with your original content is literally just a mouse click away. No messy coding or computer classes needed, just click the link in the description or go to wix.com/go/infographics and start building an amazing website in minutes. So, what is the loudest event that you've ever attended? Let us know in the comments. Also, be sure to check out our other video called Could the Black Death Happen Again? Thanks for watching, and as always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you next time!